philosophy degree? Why we're all here? What's it all about?
More like what exists, what doesn't exist, how do we know whether it exists or not, things like that.
Useful for police work?
No, not really. Except maybe teaching you to think.
And the 2-year gap in your CV around the time of your A-levels?
Gap year.
Fiona Griffiths.
Do you have any questions for me?
Questions? No. I mean, I want to move to major crimes. I don't have any questions about that.
Janet?
Cardiff Police, what is your emergency?
Yin Yigivi.
I can't understand you, caller.
They're dead. They're dead.
Who's dead?
Duris Bubati Daritis.
Caller? Are you there, caller? I can't understand.
DC Griffiths.
Bastard. Oh, God, no, not you. You're not a bastard.
I mean, you don't look like one.
Bastard thieving. Wish he'd go and drown himself. Bastard boring Henry. Excuse me?
It's Lithuanian, apparently. From a pay-as-you-go mobile, so the number's untraceable.
The street's condemned. It's just squats, drug dealers and back alleys where the Toms take their clients.
OK, Janet Mancini, not Lithuanian. 28, prostitute.
Vice have had no contact for a year, boss. They thought she'd given up.
OK, query X, prostitute, heroin addict. No query there, given the needle sticking out of her neck, except...
That needle was the only evidence of any Class A drugs on the premises. JSU found no other works, no spoons, no foil, no heroin.
Neighbours?
Ah, she kept herself to herself.
So successfully that nobody knew she had a child in there. Right, I don't want to get ahead of the PME this afternoon, but it looks like this little girl was picked up by the neck and thrown against the wall. Right. I saw the size of that unfinished job. You dropped the file on my foot.
I've just got to get the sums to add up.
Just?
I can knock the Penry case off at home at night in my own time. Multitasking. Ask anyone I'm famous for it. So, as of today, don't I work for you?
Sarge, 5 years old, in a reception class at Maypole Primary. He didn't miss it because of the school holidays.
That's on the other side of town?
It's where social services has them living. Newton Drive.
I went to a burglary up there once. Quite nice it is. Lovely views. You can see all the way to Bristol on a clear day. Do you want me to look into her finances, Sarge? I'm quite good at finances. Quite good at lots of things nobody else wants to do.
Okay, this credit card's in her handbag. It's not hers, obviously.
The school's got photos, so should I?
Yeah, get on up there, Ellie.
She looks so peaceful, don't you think? It's not peaceful, it's resigned. Like, this is just the way it is. Alive, dead, makes no difference to her.
Still bloody dead, though, isn't she? Her and that little girl. Or did you miss that bit?
DC Griffiths, Cardiff Police Force. I'm investigating a murder.
I just thought they must have gone on holiday or something.
You were friendly?
Not in each other's pockets.
Okay, it's just if we can get a key, you won't have to break anything.
Sorry.
Sarge? Sarge! That was a dead man's credit card. Brendan Rattigan, he's dead.
Yes. His Learjet went down the Bristol Channel 6 months ago. The shipping boss, remember? It's all over the news.
Yeah, no, I knew the name.
Liar.
Well, he's got no previous. Apart from a lorry load of fixed penalty notices. Motor vehicles, wearing a seatbelt, 1993. Anyway, listen, the car was cancelled, but then 3 weeks ago, someone used it to try to pay the council tax on this house.
Who said you could leave the office?
I'm using my initiative.
Don't do that. Not on the murder job. Well done.
It's company card, sir. New lighthouse, open brackets, import, export, close brackets. So I got Mrs. Rattigan's address and I'm just off up there now.
Lesson one, DC Griffiths.
Okay, you're going to say that I've already completed the action assigned, so all I need to do is write an officer's report and enter it onto Holmes 2. But you see, the thing is, out on division, they just sort of used to let me get on with it.
Yeah, we're not out on division now, Toto.
Can I go inside with you?
We'll leave that to the specialist, eh?
Yeah, but for training purposes.
I'll give you training purposes.
DC Griffiths, Major Crime.
Yeah. This
way. Is that where you found their little drawings?
Stuffed on the back. Hundreds of them.
Can I?
Be my guest. It's all forensic, I did.
Do you close the curtains?
No. Shut night and day, apparently.
You ever think, if I listen hard enough, they'll talk to me? No. Right.
Policeman still getting younger, I see.
Her first murder, first PME. Training purposes. She was a long way from home. Oftentimes, what presents as heroin overdose is nothing of the kind. It's just the body's homeostatic mechanisms getting overridden. The body gets surprised.
Dr. Price, there's no tracks on her arms. No signs of any habitual drug abuse in her flat.
There is evidence. Damage to the hyoid bone and unusually large amounts of bruising along the punctures.
Pressure on her neck? Someone holding her down?
Indicating a degree of force which might be seen as inconsistent with certain administration.
Murder by heroin injection?
Well.
Hey!
No sign of any struggle. Not even to protect the child.
Ah, yes, the child. Shall we do her now?
Ladies and gentlemen, DC Fiona Griffiths.
Well done.
Fracture of the larynx, subjacent soft tissue hemorrhage, diastatic skull fracture. Anwyn was strangled with appreciable force and thrown headfirst into the wall. Initiation test, right?
Might hit you later.
Well, just gonna have to wait until I've talked to a man about a horse, or half a horse. I mean, I know the area was beyond rough, but still. 5 years old and nobody ever heard her crying. Sarge, what was her house like? Janet's real house.
White carpets, white walls, spotless. Look, it does hit you later.
I'm not afraid of dead people.
Okay. And you fancy a drink after work? With any luck tonight, the lads will be at the Three Towns before closing time.
Oh.
Okay.
All right.
Hiya, it's Fiona again.
Still chasing that old case?
Yeah, I know.
All right, you ready?
Okay, go ahead.
The password is JD1972. So this is how many horses this Penry bloke could have bought, right?
And how many?
1,386.
How many?
Good luck, darling.
Boss wants me to follow up on Brendan Rattigan's credit card. Boss wants you to take the notes.
You may not appreciate just how much there was to do after his death.
New Lighthouse was Brendan's company. Most of it was in his head. No shareholders, just...
him firing in all cylinders and us lot running after him to catch up.
He sounds like quite a character.
It's certainly a lot quiet around here without him.
Got a record here of credit card company calling up to let us know someone was trying to use the card. Where did you say you found it?
She didn't.
Mr. Fletcher, how well did you know your boss?
I'd say we were friends. Yeah.
Do you know if he was in the habit of visiting prostitutes?
Ladies, you've clearly never met Mrs. Rattigan.
Like having a beautiful wife ever stopped a man going over the side? Or is that way inclined?
Must be important that they've sent you.
Courtesy call, Mr. Penry. Need to wrap up my old cases.
If you want a coffee, you're going to have to wash up first.
I don't drink coffee, thanks, but if you've got herbal tea... I've got a
final meeting with the CPS next week, after which I expect you'll be charged very quickly. Should I put a light on?
No.
You play that thing?
Looking for a teacher.
May I? £30,000 worth of male menopause out there you hardly ever drive. A piano you can't play. A boat that's clearly never been out to sea. And half a racehorse. You can't even sit on half a racehorse. Totting it all up on my fingers, I make it you've spent about twice as much as you stole, or allegedly stole, to pay your gambling debts. But don't you worry, Detective Inspector Penry. I've got A-level maths.
You got what you came for?
Very good.
Okay, carry on.
Griffiths.
Oi, we've been stood here waiting to buy you a drink. Celebrate the end of your first shift.
Oh, God, I completely forgot.
Okay, another time.
No, don't move. Where is everyone?
Safety numbers, is it?
No, of course not. I don't mind one-on-one. I mean...
So this guy stole the money for his half of the racehorse from a charity for handicapped children.
Some of it.
And his Metropolitan Police hero got shot in the line of duty.
But I can't trace where he got the rest of the money.
And you think that's boring?
Nobody died, Sarge.
Somebody has to die.
Yeah, well, what's the point? Janet and little Anwyn dead, and you catch the man that did it to them and you put him away forever.
We don't manage it every time. Maybe not even most of the time.
That's all I've ever wanted to do. Tourist.
Last year?
That's right.
And you decided to come to Cardiff because no one knew you there. No one would ask questions.
No. It was just when I got invalided out of the job, I decided I wanted a fresh start. I'd never even set foot in Wales before. But, you know, I figured I wanted to see where my father grew up, and it was all right. You know, well, apart from the weather and the beer. But it's a clean slate. New friends, new words for things. Cymru and Beth and all that. New words for things. Cymru and Beth and all that.
All right, Jimmy.
Had enough of you yesterday, miss.
I know. I've just got to knock this Penry case on the head.
Shut up a sec.
Two people own a racehorse together. They've got to be friends, Jimmy, right?
Not necessarily. Well, they might never have even met. It could just be an investment syndicate. Give it all up, love. Run away to the circus. Your dad'll be pleased. He's still your dad, darling.
We met when I went to work for him.
His secretary?
His accountant. Till we married. Then chatelaine of all you survey. It's not something you can really complain about out loud, but being married to a rich man is rather hard work.
So, Mrs. Rattigan, your husband made a lot of money out of his business.
It was his life.
And he spent a good deal of its money on the horses.
His money, not its money. And he wasn't really a gambling man, he just loved horses.
About his co-owners?
My husband didn't need to share.
So you don't know a man called David Penry? Sometimes goes by a codded-up Welsh name, Duff, if that Penry.
Brendan had a lot of friends.
Mrs. Rattigan, was your sex life with your husband completely normal?
Or is there some other reason he was seeing prostitutes?
Okay, I didn't mean to tread on your toes, boss, but I was pursuing my own case against Penry. He bought racehorses with Rattigan, and it seemed like an appropriate question to ask in the circumstances.
At the right point in the investigation by an experienced member of the team. For Christ's sake, apart from your procedural errors, the woman is a grieving widow.
She's so not grieving.
She's so not bloody happy, and I've got the earache to prove it.
Look, I swear to you, the first emotion she showed was when I asked her about the prostitutes, and that's just because I wasn't telling her anything she didn't already know. And at first I thought, perhaps she's not grieving because she didn't love him.
Where's this getting us exactly?
But then I thought, perhaps she's not grieving because her husband's not actually dead.
We don't do what if.
Well, did they ever find a body?
We do hard evidence on matters relating to the inquiry in hand.
Okay, but what if I just call the air accident investigation branch?
What if you just simmer down? If you want to stay on this team. I picked you for your intelligence, Fiona. Don't disappoint me now.
Are you familiar with the concept of teamwork?
Fatal accident. Yeah. Allegia.
Yes, of course, I'm familiar with the concept of teamwork.
Ditching the Bristol Channel 6 months ago.
That is my call. That's my idea.
Brendan Rattigan.
Oh. Look, the thing you have to understand about any major crime team is that every job generates this mountain of information.
Oh, what? So we all wait to be told what to do in what order while some bastard's out there killing women and children?
T.C.R. Jackson's old enough to remember the Yorkshire Ripper inquiry, where women died because the police couldn't organise their way through all the information. That's why we have rules, Fiona, to save lives. Just so you know.
Gone to the shops if I'd known.
I don't need feeding.
Personality transplant now, is it? So
I went to my first post-mortem.
Oh, love.
Well, it was fine, honestly. Round of applause when I got back to the office and everything. So I managed not to keel over or throw up, I suppose. It's a mother and a little girl. 5 years old. It's the silence that gets you. Silent five-year-old, it's all wrong. What are you looking at?
I'm not. It's just my face.
You have to stop worrying.
I don't. I'm your mother.
But I'm not that sick girl anymore, and I'm never going back there. I'm all better now. Look at me, I'm living on planet normal.
I know you are, love.
If you don't believe it, how can I? DC Griffiths, sorry to bother you so late.
Don't then.
Anne Wynne was only five, and she sat in her little window seat, and she did her drawings, and all I can think is what could have scared her so much that she never opened the curtains.
Anne Wynne was like her mother, quiet and pretty and easy to bully. Because Janet was a gentle person, forgiving. Was trying to see the best in people. Good mother. A wonderful mother. All the things you wouldn't know if you only saw them on the slab. Must get a hard heart for that kind of thing, eventually in your job.
I hope so. Janet left home because she was frightened, didn't she?
More likely because she was skint. Maybe she had an electricity bill to pay. Goes nowhere the benefit.
She had money before, though. I mean, she could afford to live round here before.
She had a man that was good to her. Maybe he died. So, end of story.
A man that gave her a credit card.
I wouldn't know.
Stacey, please. Who was she scared of?
I never asked her. She'd have told me if I'd asked her. Some friend I turned out to be.
What's important? Taking the gun or hurting me?
Taking the gun.
No. Hurting me. The gun is only dangerous because of the bad man who is holding it to your throat. So, once again, what are you gonna do? Keep the gun close to your body and protect us. Fiona! Continue. What's up?
He'll never be good enough.
You are already good. Only have to keep focus and strong.
But me, I'm weak and slow and scared and stupid.
Okay, so far DNA has been successfully extracted from a total of 32 samples from the scene, yielding 6 profiles we can identify. Of those, 2 were Janet and Anwen, leaving 4. Tony Leonard, small-time drug dealer, 38. On the night of the murder, he was detained by Her Majesty at Brixton Prison, awaiting trial on another charge. Conway Lloyd, 25, persistent offender as a juvenile.
Registered informant of mine, but he's on his holidays in Lanzarote.
Alas Kalbaitas, 39, Lithuanian national.
Like the 999 caller.
The Met have confirmed his association with the Baltic gang. Drugs, prostitution, the usual, operating until recently out of North London.
Boss, the women on the docks confirm those streets are currently out of bounds to British girls.
So, do we need to be asking, did Janet get caught up in a turf war?
Sorry, Brian.
Okay. And finally, the helpful neighbour, who had no idea where they were, thought they'd just gone on holiday.
Boss? I think I might have cocked up again. All I'm saying is we need to think very carefully about how we interview Stacey.
Is that the royal we?
And we need to see her somewhere where she feels safe, at home.
She's a person of considerable interest, maybe even a suspect.
Known to Vice. Again, they thought she'd given up.
And you may have already compromised her evidence by failing to take a proper statement.
I know, and I hold my hands up, but boss, I'm honestly not sure she's going to talk to anyone else.
Can you work with this, Ellie?
You know me. Whatever gets the dinner on the table.
Don't rush it. Research her properly. Make sure you're ready.
I screwed up a lot in my first week, too.
Cups of tea, a friendly face, health advice, needle exchange, whatever we can do to help. But the best way for the women to keep safe is to look out for each other. And that's what Stacey and Janet did.
They both give up together.
Janet said she'd had enough. She wanted to go straight before her daughter was old enough to understand. Stacey, I think she got too old.
Give us that year, Darren. Fucking taste in my mouth tonight already.
Karen.
She's better looking than that cocky bastard you brought in the other night.
Everyone's got the jitters. Sorry.
Karen! Karen! It was me the other night, watching Ellie and that cocky bastard.
I'll know you next time.
Look, who's everyone frightened of?
Really?
You're not frightened of us.
Me? I'm not frightened of any sod.
Shut up.
Because I don't go nowhere I didn't ought to go.
On Calvitus's turf. Where can I find him?
Marina.
We're looking through a boat registered under the name of Aris Calvitus. Yeah, I know it's late, but this is a murder investigation, so... Okay. We showed the harbour master a passport. The boat's called
the Valtis.
I'm going to call this one into the boss.
Hello, Stacey. Hello, it's me, it's Fiona.
What?
You okay?
Safe and sound.
I'm halfway down my second bottle when I'm old enough to know better. Do you want to come over?
Look, we'll talk tomorrow properly with my colleague and we'll do it all formally
and we'll get it right.
Do you know what really winds me up about you people?
It's just that we have rules about how we interview people, and I can't.
Yeah, right.
That's why you did such a good job on Christina.
Who's Christina?
Echo
unit 210, Stacey?
Sorry about last night.
Piss, I was in the snow this morning.
We'll see you in a bit.
Put the kettle on. Ready to rock? I stuck it on division for 3 years.
It took me nine. 9 years of stupid little junkies. Prolific offenders. The same faces coming in up the neck.
No wonder why cops end up hating the whole human race.
You always have to open your big mouth.
Stacey? Stacey? God's sakes, I spoke to her an hour ago. Stacey! I'll go around the back. Hiya. God, you gave me a fright there. Stacey?
Okay, Fiona, get back, please. Step back. Sarge, you need to get down here. We've got a situation. And there's an ambulance and a backup team now.
Bit of evidence, potentially really strong, but you got it from a slightly dodgy source.
Now what have you been up to?
You know how clumsy I am.
What are you afraid of?
Fiona, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Fiona's unique yet troubled career continues in the conclusion of all new Drama Matters Talking to the Dead, Thursday at 9 on Sky Living HD. And tomorrow sees the return of the everyday heroes of Firehouse 51. The new season of Chicago Fire starts tomorrow at 8 on Sky Living HD.